Hello everyone, and oh boy, it seems like a while since I've done a pre-recorded series on this channel. It's ages and ages ago now. I mainly just do live streams now, but the game cropped up on Steam, and with a little bit of a fanfare within the racing game and the racing sim community, it's Motorsport Manager, shall we say. And in the racing community, we haven't really had that many sort of manager type things from Motorsport. You know, you got all of your football manager stuff on that for kicking a ball around a pitch and hoping to get it into a net, but we actually haven't had like a proper Motorsport Manager sim in it, or sim. I call it a sim. I'm not entirely sure what to call it. Obviously not a sim. It's a motorsport management simulator. There we go. I believe that's the right way of saying it anyway. But yeah, so we haven't had one of these for quite a while, so I'm just gonna go and maybe do this series. I still have no idea yet if this is actually gonna become a thing, but let's just go. So we're just gonna start with a new career. I'm just gonna put the tutorials on because I have absolutely no idea how to play this game still, because I did one like sort of quick race to see if I can get used to it, and it seemed quite complicated, and that was just the quick race side. That wasn't even in the whole management thing. So we're gonna go for medium session lengths, currency symbol Great British Pounds, state format British format, and we're gonna put some auto saves on because that seems like a very good idea. Let's just continue here, and we are just gonna create our own manager. We can select his name, we do that in a bit, but as a respective former driver, your presence gives drivers a real morale boost, and happy drivers perform better within the race if you're an ex-driver. Ex-engineer, background engineering, you can help to trim down the time it takes to design new parts for your car, which take around 8 days on average, and part design time is less, 1 day less, so that could certainly be useful. Financially, your financial I'm not entirely sure how to pronounce that, will help you make the best deals on every purchase you make, and you get minus 5% on any payments you have to make. That's interesting. Political insider, your arguments carry more weight within the Global Motorsport Association, enabling you to bend the sport's rules in your favor. Voting power plus 4 in each season. Oh, that's gonna be pretty nice. Unknown, no experience, no contracts, just you and your knowledge of motorsport, and you don't get any bonuses. I'm guessing that is sort of like the hardcore mode, if you can have one. So I'm torn between like ex-driver and ex-engineer. I don't want to fall behind on upgrades if I do, because we're gonna go perhaps for like the crappiest team, or try and start from like the crappiest state. We start like in a Mana Marussia or something like that, or the equivalent. So we're gonna need those upgrades. So probably X Engineer would be a good thing to go for. I honestly have no care in the world about what my dude looks like, so I'm just gonna just do something, I don't know, bald dude. That seems okay. Glasses, no glasses, as I honestly don't have them in real life, so I guess no glasses is fine. Date of birth, I'll just randomly pick, I don't know, 12th of September, and 1988. There we go. Continent Europe. Yes, we are British. So, what should we enter as our name? What shall we do? Let's just pick a. Let's just do my name. That would be very. That would be the best way to go, shall we say? I'm not too stingy about having my name sort of out there, so auto-generate? I'm guessing that's just like auto-generate all this shit, so I don't want to do that, I've just said it all, so let's continue. Okay, where do we start? We can start in Tier 1, where basically we'll be Formula 1, I guess. tier 2 might be GP2, and tier 3 is, oh yeah, is less than that. So probably just start from the bottom, right? That would make sense. Let's start from the bottom in the European Racing Series. Alright, what team do we go? Oh, the Dragon Race team, that's pretty cool. That may on Formula E as well, like sort of Dragon Racing. Anyway. There's no one with like the, well, there is. There's that guy. That team, sorry. Which seemed like a terrible team. It says Predator may be a young team, but what they lack in experience they lack make up for in pluck. A shoestring budget forces everyone to muck in and gradually nurtured a fantastic team rapport. A small team with great potential. So that is kind of the team we probably want to go for, to be honest. Because these are all sort of similar, you know, sort of similar budgets. You know, have money, just need, you know, to win stuff. But if we start from the bottom, then we can probably work our way up. So let's do that. Predator Racing Group, nice. Ooh, so we're going Black Sea Grand Prix for our first race. Or our first race weekend, shall we say, because we're probably going to do practice and quali and all that as well. I can already see that that track is immediately more exciting than Sochi. Even though it is still a little bit grey, shall we say. Yep. Are we only doing races? Because I want to do quality sessions as well. Oh, we're doing tutorial stuff. Okay. These are two drivers. I think I know all of this already. Yeah, I know. I know. Excellent. Messina drives right on the grid. Let's get shot on the road. Oh, is this all sort of cancer tutorial? I know all this shit. Oh, wait, we're racing already? Okay, right, okay. Let's just do that then. Okay, we got Santa Ana and Evans currently furthest up to the grid. Standing is sixth. To be fair, that is pretty good. Right, well, what are the tire wears like? Because I'm wondering if the same as the proper tier 1 race that I did before. So if we... it's 10 to 12 laps for the soft tires. 6 to 8 for the... for the super softs, and we only have those two sets. Okay, right. Let's just go and race then. Why is Evans on so crappy tires? What has happened to him? that's interesting. We're gonna have to pit him relatively soon, man. Let's conserve those tires. Santa Ana's doing well. There's a big traffic jam in the middle of the track there. Shut up, Santa Ana. Oh, she's just... what was that? Jesus Christ. Dembele. Just overtook two cars in one corner. That's pretty impressive. Oh, there's a little, almost a little bit of contact there. Santa Ana is getting swamped, shall we say? Yeah, that's a good good way of saying it. We can actually probably put her up to a little bit push. Because it looks like the rest of the cars are, if I'm honest. Oh, they're getting dropped. They're getting absolutely dropped. We're at the back of the grid now. Back of the field. Scary getting past your teammate. Yeah, because Evan's on crappy tires for some reason. We probably have to pit him already. Did I accidentally do that? Or did that... was that a thing? that happens. Right. 10 to 12 laps. We probably should fuel to that much as well. Probably have to go very long on this set. Park condition, it's fine. Yeah, let's just do that. Let's probably pit Evans. That'll be a good idea. Why did he start on so worn tires? That is stupid. We've got weather forecast. It's gonna be sunny, so let's just fast forward this a bit. We're gonna see Evans come into the pits to get his fresh set of soft tires. He's also gonna fuel up. Santa Ana, we're well and truly back markers of this race. 19th and 20th, we are the true man of motor, or rather Sauber nowadays, to be honest. Back marker team. So even though Santa Ana's pushing, she's not catching the car in front. At least on that last lap. I mean, we're standing on soft tires, so it's okay with not ahead of guys on the super softs, but we're behind the rest of the guys on the softs as well, so Evans can... he's going quite long on this set of tires, so I'm just quite happy with him just staying neutral. Santa Ana... pace is doing good. She's just tagging onto the back of this little bit of a train right here. Sponsor objective. Finish 16th, but yeah, that's not going to happen. Or it might not happen, unless we get some like retirees or something. But personal best sector too, that's not too bad. But it's still 2 seconds off the guy in front. That is pretty embarrassing. Heavens, what? How are you so cramped? Santa Ana is going like 2 seconds lap faster than you on like tires that have done like 5 more laps than you. Oh well. Anyway, Evans, you are just plodding around at the back. Santa Ana, you are just... your pace is doing okay. Let's just say that. Let's just be quite generous right there. We're probably going to go quite long on this, on two super softs, two soft stints, and then go for a super soft stint in the end. Well, you've only gotten 8 laps in, and oh, because we've been pushing, that's why the tire was so bad. Probably go for another set of softs. Blue flag for Williams. Well, no one's really gone on to... oh, there's the first pitters, I guess. We've just missed pit lane. That wasn't the best idea. So we're just going to go another lap. Try and push as hard as we can. We've already run out of fuel. That is a good start to this series, I think. Running out of fuel in the first race, that is a brilliant... only because we just missed the pit lane. That is absolutely stupid. Let's conserve. Oh boy. Right, Evans may be our only chance in this race now. Yeah, but Santa Ana's run out of fuel. She's gonna back up. Oh my god, she just backed up like... oh no, that's not gone well. Oh, my fuel's gone. I know. We're going to go for another set of softs. I know, this is an absolutely terrible first race for Sandra, and all the fuel's gone. But she did make it to pit lane, to be fair, on an empty tank. Santa Ana drops to 20th. If she still gets past Evans, that'll be freaking hilarious, but... Yep, yeah, it's not been a very good first race for Predator Racing, I don't think. I mean, Evans is just being Evans, and Santa Ana are out of fuel, you know. You can't really... I mean, this race could go worse, one of us could crash, but I'm probably going to be jinxing it right now. Tire wear's not helping my lap times, yes I know. Have you just passed pit lane as well, or are you just coming up to it? You are... Tell you what, Evans, do one more lap. And then push on that lap, I guess. Santa Ana's doing okay. Yep, Evans, do one more lap, just push. Overtake mode for Evans is probably like normal pace for everyone else, but I'm moving too hard on him. Right. Have you just missed pit lane there, Evans? Because I think you may have. I should have done the pit. Ah, god damn it. god. Right, let's just go another set of softs. Fuel it up. Parts fine. Let's go balanced. He's gonna miss pit lane. Okay. Anyway, he's got enough fuel for it, so it's fine. I think it's Santa Ana's back there, and she's yeah, this is how crap Evans is. There we go. Yeah, okay, stop complaining, Santa Ana. You're 19th and 20th isn't that much of a difference, to be honest. There we go. Put new tyres on Evans' car. Ooh, almost a collision out the side of the pits there. That was pretty close. There's still no rain on the way, so we're looking good. Track grip is going up. Where... Evans is like... Actually, he's not too far... Oh no, he is really far behind. I'm reading that wrong. He's about 30 seconds behind the next guy, so he's just going to probably just plod around at that moment. You know, Santa Ana's doing okay, I guess. She can actually push pretty hard at this stage in the race. Let's go high fuel usage. Oh, that's Evans' high fuel usage. Santa Ana, you want to go high fuel usage. Because you have plenty of fuel to get to the next stop. You could probably push a bit as well. Restate a screen flag. Does that mean there are safety cars, potentially? A red flag means the session has been stopped. Blue flag means the driver get left. Fine, so finally, a check flag means the session finished. So there's no safety cars. Ah. They probably had that in an update, but to be honest. Feeling quite a bit tired. Let's make a couple more laps, Santa Ana, then we can potentially pull on some super softs. Just go as far as you can on the soft set. So we don't... Warnings about a few parts now. Okay. Yeah, the engine's gonna probably go pop in a bit. I think it takes like 10 seconds to fix that. But we don't want her retiring. So let's just fix it. Actually, we didn't change the tires, so bring super softs, fuel to ends. We got 9 laps left, so let's stick 9.96 laps of fuel there in. Yeah, let's go. 9 laps remaining after pit stop, so we got the 9.96, that'll be fine. Park condition, fix that crap. We're going to spend a long time in the pits, but as long as she doesn't... as long as she doesn't break down. That's the word I was looking for. Or the words I was looking for. Can you take my... Oh, he's having gearbox problems now. Oh, come on. Right. Let's fix that. Probably fix the engine while we're at it. Fix that. Fuel to the end of the race. Let's just get to the end. That would be a good idea. Put on some super softs. And let's go. Change that. Bring Evans in to get his crap repaired. Yeah, he's gonna take a while. Problem with the fueling? Things definitely haven't gone well in this first race of ours. Let's just say that. Oh well. I wasn't really sure what I was expecting, because I was basically like thrown into this first race, and I was like, okay. So we're not going to do any management things before we actually do the race. That makes sense. Let's watch this fuel. They're all both good on fuel. Both good on tires. Should be to the end anyway. Why don't we push these tires? Let's do that. I mean, we can't finish more than like 92. Well, 92 seconds off of the next guy. That is pretty embarrassing, to be honest. I mean, we had to fix our cars and we had to, you know, we had problems, so. We're about 6 seconds off the pace of the fastest guys. That is pretty ridiculous, to be honest. So we didn't get our sponsor objective, but these guys can actually both go into high fuel usage as well. Oh well, I don't think that went well, to be completely and utterly honest. Can we put fresh tires soon? No, it's the end of the race. It's all, like 3 laps to the end. Oh, it's going to be like even less for us. Yep. These guys need to just go and overtake Mars. You're going through these tires like a fat guy goes through hot dogs, man. Okay, then. Blue flag for William Evans. That is pretty much permanent. Santa Ana's just like run out of super soft tires. No, because we're one lap from the end. Are we just one lap down or something? Now she has a brake issue or. Yep. Puncture. That's it. Puncture. Oh well. That really didn't go that well, shall we say. Evans is still going. Poor Evans. Messed up on his initial starting tire, where he was on like a half or three quarters already degraded tire before when they started the race, so that is not the greatest race. Not the greatest tragic calls for me as well, because I missed them going past the pit lane, which is kind of stupid, but 1-2 for whoever that team is. Garda Racing. Good for them, I guess. Let's see how our strategies like fared up against everyone else's. Yeah, we went on like a 2-stop, but everyone else looked like they went on a 3-stop. Oh no, not everyone else went on a 3-stop, a 4-stop. Jesus Christ, why would you pit for Supersoft like 2 laps from the end? That is, and they had the winning strategy. So either those guys are really fast, or they just messed up in their strategy yet still won, which means they're still really fast. Right, okay. I mean, 4-stop, 4-stop, 3-stop, 3-stop. I guess it was a battle between the 3 and the 4-stop. Okay, yeah, mostly it's a 3-3-3. They did a 2 there. It's 2 valid, but they finished, yeah. And, yeah, Evans messed up, so. I mean, we pitted around the same time for the other guys for the soft tires, and then pitted here for super softs, which went a bit longer than we thought, or a little bit shorter life than we thought, really. Especially at the end of the race, yeah, because these guys did 6 laps on the tires, 6 laps, 4 laps on the tires. We did 8, so I mean, there's a couple of 8s here, but you know, and we also pushed too much on that tire again, I think as well. We're going into scrutineering. Scrutineering complete. No rules broken. Doesn't mean you can break rules. That's awesome. I don't think we got some points. We just got 3 points. Penalties. Driver gains 2 extra points for what? For driving the fastest lap. Oh, so it's like sort of NASCAR fastest lap extra points thing. Okay, yeah, that's fine. Constructors' Championship, we're dead last. We are dead last, so we gotta put some upgrades on this car. Probably some better drivers. We need a better driver than Santa Ana. We need a better driver than whoever the other dude was. I still can't even remember his name. Yeah. So let's do management stuff. Let's do that thing. But this is actually gaining on quite on the long side for an episode right now. We're going up to 30 minutes, so I'll probably cut this one short here, and we'll be back for the more management stuff of Motorsport Manager, which you would have thought was the idea, but they seem to throw straight into a race first off. So I'll see you guys next time.